2,000 volunteers, 92 locations, 13 radio stations, and 4 television stations, all united for the United Way Day of Caring. Here's their story.
Hi, I'm Ned Reynolds. Thank you very much for joining us for a special presentation, which I think you're going to find very rewarding. See what it says across the t-shirt there? Live United. That's what we're going to talk about for the next hour. Living in a manner in which we can help everybody succeed. That's what we're all about. Helping, volunteering, that's what we do when we live united and live the United Way. I'm surrounded by my fellow compatriots from the media profession, and they're saying, wait a minute, you're all competitors. And that's exactly right, we are. Sure, we compete against each other. You do too, in your business venture, whatever it might be. But it doesn't mean that you don't band together to help others. And that's what United Way is all about. We're all affected in one way or the other by the various agencies that are funded by United Way. That's the secret of living united. Remember, united we stand. And as my fellow members will tell us,
most of us know how hard it can be to keep up with yard work in the summer months and could use a little help. That's especially true for some seniors.
Right, and that's where the Hands-On for Seniors program comes in, volunteers helping seniors to stay in their homes.
Oh, it just feels awesome. I just can't believe that this is happening to me, but it's just so wonderful.
Well, today is Day of Caring, and so we are here with some teams from O'Reilly's, and O'Reilly's is working with Hands-On for Seniors, which is a program that's funded through the Greene County Senior Citizens Tax Fund. So as a part of United Way, it's managed out of the United Way of the Ozarks office, and we really are working with seniors to help them stay in their homes longer and to live independently. Today we're doing 7 or 8 Hands-On for Seniors projects. So it's a really big day and we have a lot of volunteers engaged.
Well, I do whatever they tell me to do. I'm kind of the lowest man on the totem pole being my first year. So I just don't want to mess anything up. So they tell me to lift something, I'll lift it, and wash something, I'll wash it.
Company email about 8 years ago went out asking for volunteers, and I thought it'd be something pretty cool to do. You know, I have a special needs child, so I thought it'd be pretty cool to give back a little bit, so pay it forward. You know, seniors and special needs people, especially, you know, I enjoy working, taking care of those, you know, the group homes and senior housing and things like that.
But we're really looking for people who need some exterior work done. So we do a lot of yard work. You know, it's really one of those things where you've got some seniors who they may have to decide between medications or, you know, mowing their lawn. And so unfortunately, sometimes that becomes a problem. And working with United Way, I get to see multiple agencies and all different capacities that are really coming together in a united way, really to help the people in our communities. So for this project on Day of Caring, we're helping our homeowner to really revamp the exterior of her home. So they've taken down all of her shutters and they've washed them. They're power washing the house, planting some flowers. Here in a little while, we'll have the lawnmower going and they're going to really clean up the yard and make it fantastic for her. I talked with Doris this morning and the first thing she said when I asked her, how are you today? She said, I am overwhelmed. Just blown away by the generosity of the people that are here helping her on Day of Caring, and she was very thankful.
Just great, awesome, like I just cannot believe it. It's just overwhelming. I have lived here for about 20 years. I rented the house before I really bought it, but I used to be able to get up on a ladder and hand worship myself, and now I can't even get up on a ladder to change my light bulbs. I really, really appreciate it from the bottom of my heart.
Everybody needs a helping hand from time to time. You know, anytime in a community such as ours, you can get involved. Not only are you helping the people that need the help, but you also get a good experience out of it. So I suggest it highly.
When you see someone who's so thankful that you're there, it just makes your heart so warm to know that you were part of helping them to retain that independence. You know, they don't want to stop doing things for themselves. My parents are elderly, senior, you know, they have some health problems. My dad has a hard time getting around. And so to have someone who is really caring and really takes time to do something for them that they can't do, it just really is an amazing experience to see firsthand how thankful people are that we're able to do something for them like this. And many of them, like Doris,
have volunteered and given their time in the past, and so now it's their turn to receive some of that giving.
United.
The saying goes, it takes a village to raise a child. And here's another organization that's giving local parents that extra support.
The Boys and Girls Clubs of Springfield is a safe place for kids to just be kids. And Eva Jefferson says having that stability helped her dream big for her future.
11 years ago, I was right out of foster care. I moved back in with my dad, and I started first grade at Kimball Elementary, and I met my best friend Megan, and she went to the Boys and Girls Club, and she told me all about it. She loved it, and so I begged my dad to bring me here, and he loved it, and it took a lot off his shoulders because I had somewhere to go after school, and so I've been here ever since. It takes a lot off the parents' shoulders because they know their kids are in a safe environment where they can grow and learn and be a kid. Boys and Girls Club's motto is great futures start here, and I think that sums it up pretty much. I mean, growing up here, I now have a positive future to look forward to, and I can go to college now, and I can have a dream. They allow me to really just be myself and go for whatever I want to go for.
We work together as a team because we want kids to grow up to care about the community. We want them to be smarter. We want them to be in education. We want to have them to be good stewards and grow up to be good citizens. So it's very, very crucial that we get the support from the community on that. I mean, we can't do what we do without, you know, support. I mean, Boys and Girls Clubs has over 100 employees, huge buildings. We have to pay our utility bills and insurance bills just like everybody else. Our fees are kept really low thanks to people like the United Way and supporters of the United Way that do so much for us so that we can help our kids and our parents. Here in Springfield and the Ozarks, they support 20 plus great charities in the community. So it's a win-win for the community. Makes a good climate for job development, for safe neighborhoods, and fighting some of the negatives that are out there.
United Way, for me, it kind of goes both ways. I can volunteer and help out them and enjoy my passion of just helping people, and then they also help the club in a lot of ways. We do a lot of community service, and I kind of found my passion for helping, and I thank the Boys and Girls Club for allowing me to find that.
United. When disaster strikes, those in crisis can count on one agency to immediately respond.
The American Red Cross mobilizes so families can have urgent needs met, housing, food, and clothing. It also works to save lives even before disaster strikes.
Over the last year, Red Cross has helped over 531 families recover from disaster.
Fires, floods, tornadoes, families are often caught in the chaos and left with nothing.
In cases of like fires, they've generally lost everything, down to they come out with whatever's on their backs.
Stacy Burks is development director for the American Red Cross Southern Missouri. Its mission, to prevent and alleviate human suffering during emergencies.
Not everybody in the community has a friend or a family member that they can reach out to. So Red Cross is there to help those who may not have someone to help them. We're there to provide that safety net to help them begin their recovery and their road to get back into their life, get back to work.
Springfield averages just over 3 fire deaths each year.
The Red Cross has a goal to reduce home fires by 25% by the year 2020. And so we do this through our home fire preparedness program by joining volunteers, Red Cross volunteers, as well as local firefighters to install free smoke alarms in homes where they either don't have them or where they're not working. We also offer free batteries to people in their homes to replace in their smoke detectors.
During Day of Caring, volunteers went door to door giving families a little peace of mind.
63% of residential fires in Springfield happen in rental properties. 57% of those families impacted have income below $15,000. So it's definitely Something that we see in more impoverished areas.
And a good number of those properties house children.
In those homes, 29% of our client households have children under the age of 12.
The American Red Cross offers help to families during the first 72 hours following a disaster.
That includes food, shelter, medication, could include medical supplies. It also can include clothing and whatever their individual needs may be in order to help them recover. On average, it's around $550 per family per disaster. And so that money would not be available if it were not for the help for United Way donations.
Donations that also help save lives.
Last year, we installed over 500 smoke alarms in homes throughout southern Missouri. This year, our target is 1,500 smoke alarms. And we do this by bringing everyone together to either canvas. We have smoke alarm hotline that people can call, and they'll have our local, we'll make an appointment for their local fire department to come out and install for them.
It's an effort that brings strangers together on a path toward a common goal.
And so working together, we can make our community a safer place to live. And these type of community preparedness groups and this type of community involvement is what it looks like to live united.
Well, I appreciate the concern of Red Cross itself in helping out individuals, because there are some people in the park here do not have smoke alarms.
Hi.
Hi.
With the Red Cross.
Uh-huh.
Lisa Rose,
KY3. Yes, I recognize you.
How are you?
Fine, how are you?
Just great. So can we come in and see
sure.
your smoke alarms?
Bedroom there, and then there's a bedroom there.
Okay.
You're going to love this.
Well, when we first moved in here, we had the old ones. And every time I turned the stove on, they would just blast. So I just took them down. Took the batteries out.
Well, so this is going to be much better.
Much better, yes, because you can turn off the quiet button.
You want to keep that.
Okay.
We take the box back because FEMA, the government, actually buys this, but this is from a grant.
Uh-huh.
And so we return the boxes they along with your information, and they know that some money
grant,
was spent.
Good.
Now, if you want to, you can press the button closest to the light that's flashing, and that's the test. So go ahead and press that button.
Hi, Becky. We're back.
You're back.
We're here with the United Way Day of Caring, and we want to know if it's okay if we check your smoke alarm.
Sounds wonderful.
Okay.
I've got four.
You have four. Great.
Yes, the one in the living room. It goes off by itself every once in a while just for fun. Drives me nuts. I retired from O'Reilly corporate office, and my boss, Mary Saber, did this every year, and I just think it's awesome.
Captain, how many fires have you responded to that a smoke alarm has made a difference in saving a life or getting a family out safely?
I would say that at least 90% of the fires that we respond to, if there's occupants and they've been alerted to that, that has made a huge difference.
We hear about having a fire escape plan. How many people actually have one, and how critical is it?
It's essential, especially for kids and stuff that don't necessarily know what to do in those types of situations. It helps save a lot of time getting out when you already know what you need to do.
You can also make it fun, right, when you're trying this out. How do you make it fun for kids?
You can make it a game, do time drills, make sure you're getting out in under 2 minutes, show them different ways to be able to get out.
We just bought this place recently, and I really thought that we had some, you know, maybe that they just were old or whatever, but I got to look in last night to show you guys where to take the old ones down, and we don't have any, so.
That's going to be scary. What did you think when you saw that?
It was very scary. I have a 16-year-old son, and, you know, you just never know. Accidents happen.
We're KSPR 33.
And we live united.
One of the many agencies that the United Way helps fund is Lutheran Family and Children's Services, which focuses on helping parents provide a healthy and stable home for their children.
Yeah, for one single mom, it got her kids off the street, into a home, and hope for the future.
It's devastating.
Homeless, with two young children and another on the way, Cami Quinte bounced from shelter to shelter.
You know, going from place to place, not knowing where you're going to lay your head out at night. When I was homeless, I was riding the bus all day long just till I could figure something out.
One of those bus rides brought her to Lutheran Family and Children's Services, where Cami says her life and those of her children finally started to turn around.
it just made it so much easier for me.
It's been a real blessing to work with Cami.
LFCS caseworker Amanda McVicker took care of Cami's homeless problem first, getting her off the bus and into a real home.
So I was able to take her and her kiddos in my car, and we went and found an apartment for her.
Just in time for the birth of Cami's third child, Amanda then turned to helping Cami provide for those children, bringing her much-needed baby and household supplies. And once she was ready, LFCS worked on getting Cami back into the workforce so she could provide for her kids herself.
This is the best place that I've ever came to that actually helped me and stuck through with it.
She's made a lot of progress.
LFCS Regional Director Laura Farmer says her agency is able to help people like Cami so much because they're a United Way agency. She says the funding they receive for that allows them to create a safety net for those in need and build a stronger community.
We meet certain community red flag issues, and we're out there to try to prevent child abuse and neglect or end homelessness and really meet some of the community's needs.
It is so rewarding to be able to help these families achieve their full potential.
And you can get that same feeling by supporting United Way and their partner agencies like LFCS, either by donating money or time.
Your gift to the United Way impacts children and families in our community. The money stays local and is really there to address those issues that we have identified in our community as important.
So if you donate or volunteer or give your time, it's helping those families in ways that are just immeasurable.
Cami says she and her children and their bright future ahead are living proof of that.
I don't know, this place is a lifesaver.
Every parent knows what it's like to need a break.
But few will ever face the challenges and rewards of raising a child with special needs.
The Ark of the Ozarks is a local nonprofit that strives to hear the needs of individuals and families here in the Ozarks and help them find solutions.
Our next video tells the story of a father, his daughter, and this one-of-a-kind program that helps them both live fuller lives.
I started bringing my daughter to the Ark of the Ozarks rec program when she was around, I think, 4 years old. We started bringing her and we've loved it ever since. Natalie was born with cerebral palsy, scoliosis, hydrocephalus. She couldn't walk or talk or do anything on her own. The Ark of the Ozarks rec program meant a lot because I was the expert on my daughter. And even when I left her with close family members, I felt guilty because they don't know when she's happiest, when she's, you know, when she needs something, you know, because she was nonverbal. The Ark of the Ozarks people, they all picked up on that and they knew how to make her happy. And I could just leave her and I know, okay, this is the best place for her today. I mean, I don't have to feel bad. I know that I can leave and she wants to be here. And it was just a relief and I could actually go and have a few hours by myself and really, truly guilt-free relax.
It's really a dual benefit. Raising a disabled child can be very hard and take a lot of time. And for a parent to be able to drop their son or daughter off to our program with caring individuals that have structured activities for them, benefits the child because he's learning new skills, he's meeting peers, he's learning socialization skills. Mom's free to go get her shopping done, get her housework done without worrying about her child and who's taking care of the child. United Way has supported our summer and Saturday therapeutic recreation programs for years. And those programs, and a lot of the kids with disabilities we serve are out of school for the summer. We work with the school system to continue working on academic skills, work on their mobility, work on socialization in a fun therapeutic environment.
The ARC does so many vocational things. They help these kids become valuable members in the community. And I think that's a huge thing for the kids themselves to know that I'm not just disabled, I can contribute. I can be a part of society, you know, I have so much value, more than people can see. And they help these kids with job placements, they help them with all sorts of just worthwhile endeavors normally they wouldn't be able to do. Natalie passed away in November of 2013. She was 12 years old. I really look back at Natalie's life and I don't have many regrets because I know that I did everything I could to take care of her and make her happy, and the program is part of that. The rec program is part of that, and I can't stress how important that is. to know that even when I wasn't taking care of her, that in the summers I could take her to a place that would make her even more happy than I think I did at times. I know that she lived as full a life as she could when she was here. And even on her last days, I knew how happy she was. I know because of the Ark of the Ozarks, I made her happy. And that's so valuable for parents. I think United Way is an extremely valuable organization because they really focus on the needs of the community. They really identify what gives back to our area the best. Without the United Way, there would be no organizations like the Ark of the Ozarks, which are extremely important for people in the community. Sometimes big organizations, it's hard to see the return. It's hard to know that your money is going for your community, but for the United Way, you really see that the money goes directly into your community, the places where it's needed, and the places where it can really affect the people around you.
We are Scripps and we live united.
Woo! 1 in 7 people in our region don't know how they will get their next meal.
And Lisa, that's where the Salvation Army in fact steps in. It serves more than 3,000 meals every single month, just one of many essential needs met by an army of volunteers.
Just in the month of July alone, we had 292 phone calls that said, can you help me?
Major Judy Mills with the Salvation Army is often face to face with families in need.
We want folks to understand that they're not alone in their situation, that although they may have reached a rough patch, and for some folks, it may be the very first time that they've come before us and they don't know the system, so to speak. They don't know what questions to ask. They don't know what area to go to, which agency will be able to meet their needs.
From back to school supplies to housing to feeding, the Army and its volunteers rescue those who arrive with no hope.
We have seen many, many people that God has brought through our doors that come many times as a last resort, near tears. Some of them come and do sit in our offices and just cry. And many times what we need to do is just listen to their story and help them to understand what their need really is.
And those needs are very real. Harbor House, a men's shelter, served 860 meals in a month. It offered lodging to over 1,000. The Family Enrichment Center served 1,300 meals in a month and provided 408 nights of lodging. A senior feeding program supplied 600 meals in the same month. And a summer day camp program that offers children breakfast, a snack, and lunch tallied 1,800 meals.
We are a faith-based grouping. We are a faith-based religion, and I want folks to understand that we open our doors to anybody and everybody. And so whatever we have as far as programming with regarding the church, we also incorporate regular youth programming and community programs for women and men that are open to anybody.
And the program with the highest visibility is this one. More than 440 volunteers brave the cold to log more than 3,200 hours.
But also because of this community, there is an amazing amount of very philanthropic thinking here, where people are willing to give financially as well as their energies and time. Obviously, our Christmas effort is a huge portion of our yearly budget, and that's why that Christmas emphasis of ringing the kettlebell is so very, very vital to us keeping our doors open. And what we've found is that having our doors open to help with those emergency situations will temporarily help a family. But we are also trying to institute a brand new program within the Salvation Army called our Pathway of Hope, which helps the caseworker work alongside a family to help them to learn what is going on in their lives, what is happening with their finances, what type of changing needs to take place for them to get from the poverty or under poverty level to a level where they can be financially solvent, as well as, again, independent living and not having to come repeated times to different agencies to gain help, to help themselves.
And if you're wondering what difference can be made with just a few coins in a kettle,
we've had many men who, while they are with us at Harbor House, who have gone to OTC or have completed college and have been able to go on and be productive members again of society.
And many more people are being reached with help from the United Way.
Without the support of the United Way, we certainly wouldn't be able to financially do what we're able to do in helping people, because running any type of organization You have to have administrative and overhead costs, but we try to keep those costs to a minimum so that we have more finances available to help the clients that God brings through our doors.
Salvation Army also gets help from the Ozarks Food Harvest.
And your help is greatly appreciated through donations of money and time.
We're Color 10 and Z27,
and we live united.
Changing lives one meal at a time. Jesus Was Homeless was founded back in 2008. And each week, volunteers serve more than 1,200 meals to families living on the fringe here in Branson.
The fact that I once used to be one of those people in a hotel and being without, and now it's actually giving me a chance to go back to the same place where I once was and to give to somebody else in the same position that I was in.
They arrive at night when families are starting to wonder how their children will sleep on empty stomachs.
We hear all the time that they didn't understand the need here, and because we're a tourist town and you just don't see it. And so when people can be exposed to us, it's huge that they can see the actual need and how we're reaching that need.
Volunteers spend their Thursday mornings making meals, packing bags, and their Thursday evenings making deliveries. They hand out free food to 27 weekly rate or extended stay hotels. Families choose the hotels as a transition, a stopgap before securing something better. Something that may never come.
Every week we pack about 1,200 meals.
On this date in August, community volunteers joined Jesus Was Homeless, putting sandwiches, chips, fruit, and drinks into sacks.
We could not operate at the scale that we're operating without volunteers. We are 99.8% driven by volunteers.
And they are always needed to pack food, drive vans, teach enrichment classes, and to offer support on the streets of Branson. Jesus Was Homeless is a community group dedicated to serve those who are hungry, homeless, and hurting. It provides opportunities to grow spiritually, relationally, and physically.
It lets people know that people within their own community care, and that's the number one thing. When somebody can show that they care for you, it inspires and gives hope.
Along with meals, the group offers employment training and access to health care.
I'm a recovering addict. I've got 6 months clean now, and that's a direct result of somebody coming to my room and passing out sandwiches at my hotel, and now I have the opportunity to give back and talk to people that are in the same boat I am.
When you're in that survival mode, you're in just surviving the day to day. And so what we try to do as an organization through our volunteers is provide next steps. So offer hope and a way out of that.
Today, we are so excited because we are working together as a community. We have some great companies and organizations in our community here in Branson, Taney, Stone County. It's a chance for folks out in the community that maybe don't know what Jesus Was Homeless was doing, or maybe doesn't understand what Christian Action Ministries is doing.
And I fell in love with Branson, my wife and I did, and this is a really good place to get involved and have a sense of family and community. It's just kind of my philosophy that, you know, what's going to strengthen our country is a sense of community again, where we lift people up in the communities and those that have been blessed, share that blessing with those less fortunate. That are deserving and hardworking.
Jesus Was Homeless is a non-denominational 501c3 that serves people from all backgrounds. A statement of faith or participation in religious activities is not required to volunteer or receive help. And organizers say United Way plays a big role in its success.
And having United Way involved in it is huge for us, because if we didn't have community partners like United Way, not only would we not have volunteers, but we wouldn't have the funds available to serve the folks that are really in need.
Growing poverty rates in our community affect everyone, leaving some parents wondering how they'll pay for their children's basic needs. That's where the group Kids First comes in, removing barriers so children can thrive in the classroom.
There you go. Now you got it figured out. Watch it.
First grader Jacob is getting a test he won't face in the classroom.
V-O-H-Z-E.
But one that will certainly help him there.
Is it better, do you think, number one or better number two?
If Jacob has poor eyesight and it goes undiagnosed, his classroom work will suffer.
We really look at what are those barriers to learning. So in Springfield Public Schools, that's our focus. How can we remove those barriers to learning so that they can be successful?
Jean Graybeal is the Director of Health Services at Springfield Public Schools.
So Kids First, as I said, is all about removing barriers to learning. So we know that if a child is homeless, or if they didn't eat the night before, or the last time that they ate was at the school setting, or if they have a chronic health condition, or if they can't their parents can't afford the medication that they need to assist with that chronic health condition, that's a barrier to learning.
It's a simple concept figured out pretty quickly by educators who saw children coming into the classroom unprepared to learn.
You kind of think, well, you know, everyone has that. And what we see on a daily basis is that we have lots of children in need, and they don't have those basic needs met.
Often that need is a medical emergency.
And I don't know if you've ever had dental pain at all, or your mouth hurts because you've got a toothache and you know what that feels like. Well, imagine a little child who has multiple cavities that are in, and they're hurting and it's uncomfortable, which also increases the chance for them to have an infection as well and become ill. So then that increases the likelihood that they're going to be absent from school and they're not going to eat well because it hurts to eat well. So then imagine having a fund where we can assist children to get that dental care that they need.
In many cases, a simple toothbrush can enhance learning by building self-esteem.
You can't imagine what kids, it's like it's Christmas when they receive a new toothbrush and toothpaste and some soap, because maybe their family doesn't have that at home.
And that's if the child has a home.
But the majority of our homeless population are elementary students. So if they're sleeping in the car the night before, did they get enough rest so that they could perform well? No.
Today, Jacob passed his eye exam.
Okay, you did a great job. You don't need any glasses, okay?
He won't need glasses this year.
If you need something before then, let me know.
United Way of the Ozarks makes it possible for Jacob and all kids to come first.
Our rates for free and reduced lunch continue to grow. Our poverty rates continue to grow. Those that are food insecure continue to grow. So we have to step up to the plate. And one of the groups that have stepped up to the plate over and over again has been United Way.
We're Midwest family, and
we live united!
Different local agencies work year-round to find solutions to the problem of teen homelessness. One agency opens its doors to those youth is rare breed in Springfield. A recent survey by Community Partnership of the Ozarks looked at the issues that puts kids on the streets and what can be done to find them a permanent place to call home.
When Xavier Curvin got into a heated argument with his mother at age 17, it was the last straw and he was kicked out of his house.
I was homeless there for a while. I was like basically couch surfing with friends and stuff and didn't have like a whole lot of like choices, like family or anyone to talk to at this time.
50% of youth who found themselves homeless alone say they were kicked out like Curvin. And the survey points to several family issues brewing in their lives. Half have had parents who abused alcohol or drugs. Half have been witnesses or victims of trauma. And almost half have struggled with a mental illness.
To me, that says there are problems that are happening within the home. These problems are not being addressed, and these youth are then becoming homeless because they are being kicked out of abusive homes.
The survey also found 55% of those who were homeless identify as members of the LGBTQ community.
We need to educate ourselves, and we need to stop judging and realizing that these are kids that we are throwing away.
Lonnie Brewer, the director at Rare Breed Youth Services, says community members should start conversations with a youth who may have a few cuts or bruises or is wearing the same clothes.
Here, what we find at the center is asking a youth how your day was. We're the first person that's asked them a question and that they have that's even cared about them that day, and then they start telling the story of what has happened.
One of those conversations led Curvin to Rare Breed 3 years ago.
Like, because I was antisocial back then, really didn't open up to a whole lot of people. I think me working with like other youth and stuff like benefits me, like helps me.
Kervin now has plans to attend college and is also working on finding a job. Rare Breed offers free and confidential services to youth ages 13 to 20 who need help. Since June of 2000, the Rare Breed Youth Outreach Center has provided a clean, safe, and sober place for homeless, runaway, and at-risk youth in Springfield. And it doesn't have to be something that happens after a teen's homeless. Rare Breed staff can help mediate between youth and families when conditions seem hopeless.
We are iHeartMedia and
We Live United!
Our youngest generation is vital to our future success as a community, but some struggle to even find a safe place to sleep.
One local agency aims to help the youngest members of our community, one bed at a time. At Great Circle, a place to sleep means more than just getting a good night's rest.
If you don't have a safe place, or food to eat, or clothes to wear, then you can't get yourself up to go to school. Then you're open to people being taken advantage of for other people in the community.
That's why since 2009, Great Circle, formerly Boys and Girls Town, has offered short-term shelter services for homeless youth and children suffering from abuse or neglect.
Literally a place to lay their head, someplace safe, someplace they can go to get food, to get clothes, they can get a good night's sleep. Many of these kids do not have a safe place to lay their heads, and so we're able to provide that for them.
Emergency shelter manager Holly Hunt says rates for abuse and neglect and homeless youth keep increasing every year. The 20 beds at their shelter almost always full.
We average about one kid a day that comes through our doors. The year before last, we had 382 kids come through, and the last year we had 360. This year we're on track to be on even more than that.
Most of the kids who show up at Great Circle are foster children.
They've been a shooting or a meth lab, or they've been neglected, and they need a safe place to come. They've had something traumatic happen, so they're able to come here and we're able to provide them the services they need, medical attention, therapeutic services, family mediation. Hopefully we'll be able to provide them a safe place to go so they can, Children's Vision can work together to find maybe grandma or a foster home or figure out an appropriate long-term placement.
Through the help of United Way, the staff is able to continue serving those most vulnerable in our community.
United Way helps us provide the staff to watch the kids. They help provide clothes, shampoo, shoes. Anything you need to run a household, United Way helps provide us the basic support services that we need.
Hunt says although those who seek shelter here have gone through tough times, there's hope.
When they start coming out of their shell, when they begin talking, we've had kids that will not talk. When they start talking to you or smiling at you, some of the smallest things are the most rewarding.
But the ultimate reward for the kids to have a better, brighter future.
Our kids need a support system here in the community, and we're able to be one part of that support system. You don't want kids literally on the street or in the unsafe situations, so the emergency shelter is able to provide them a safe place to begin their healing process and hopefully get back on their feet and make sure they're in a safe environment.
Great Circle provides its services to those ranging from infants to 18-year-olds. Prior to Great Circle, the shelter was known as Boys and Girls Town, and before that, Springfield Children's Orphanage.
The agency could always use donations like cooking and washing supplies, as well as children's clothes for its shelter. If you'd like to help, you can call 417-865-1646.
The Harmony House takes in people who have nowhere else to go, people trying to escape abusive relationships.
It's the only violence prevention shelter in Greene County.
It could be spousal abuse or even emotional or financial abuse.
Harmony House is empowering women to leave the abuser. The success rate is exceeding the national average.
Day of Caring is a wonderful event for our organization. One of the things they do, for example, we have a group that's doing a deep cleaning of our kitchen. That's something we never have time to do during the year. And to come in and have that kitchen deep cleaned, you know, behind the appliances, just scrubbed from top to bottom, is hugely helpful. So the Day of Caring volunteers really save us a lot of money in staff time and in actual budget that we would have to pay out to have the work done. If we didn't have those United Way dollars, we wouldn't be able to do as much. The little things really do add up. If a United Way partner company out in Springfield does a silverware drive or a linen drive or a personal hygiene item drive, We use those items all the time, and we use them for the women to either we use them in shelter or we give them to the women when they leave. So it does all add up because we go through a lot of supplies. You'd be amazed at how many women come here and they don't have a name for what they've been going through. They don't recognize it as domestic violence. In many cases, it's what they've known. Maybe they grew up in a household where there was domestic violence, and so it's sort of normal, but yet they knew that they were at risk and they needed to get away. But I can't imagine living in a truck and fearing for your life and having to move the truck every day to make sure that your abuser wasn't on your trail. And, you know, those stories just break your heart because there's kids, and you know that this woman is really in danger. I mean, we deal with life and death in many, many cases. Children who grow up in abusive homes have a lot of stomach disorders and headaches and anxiety. It impacts their learning, and they are at great risk of growing up to repeat the behavior in their own lives. So, you know, they will either choose an abuser as a partner or they will become the abuser. So, you know, that's one of the reasons that it's so important to get these women and children out of those homes and break the cycle, hopefully once and for all. The national average is that women will leave their abuser 7 to 8 times before they make the final break. Our average is 1.5 times, so we have a much lower rate of return. And we believe that's because of not just our services, but all of the services that are available in Springfield, the support system that we have. This is actually our third shelter. We started out in a small rental home that I want to say had maybe like 12 or 15 beds. And then there was another house on Walnut Street that had more beds. And now we're here on Cherry Street, where we can accommodate 110, and we're full every night. We have 110 women and children in shelter every night. In 2010, we turned away 491 women and children who qualified for services, meaning that we assessed that they were in imminent danger. In 2014, that number jumped to 2,326 that we had to turn away and say, you know, keep calling us. Call us tomorrow, call us the day after that. We will get you in as soon as we have a bed. And last year turned away 2,326 because we were full. One of the things that I've noticed most since I started working at Harmony House is the number of women, when they find out where I work, the number of women who have said, that happened to me. That has been probably the biggest surprise that I've had, because it really is very, very common, and people just don't talk about it.
One day in August, 2,000 people in work clothes showed up at various schools and charities across the Ozarks.
Day of Caring gets volunteers busy making repairs, painting, and cleaning. In one day, they do work that would have taken months, and it is the very definition of your United Way.
People always say to me, well, why the United Way? And I look at it this way. We're really trying to do two things. One is we want to meet the immediate needs of people. We say that we want to be the safety net. The other thing that we're trying to do too is to really mobilize the power of volunteers. We just had Day of Caring, over 2,000 people doing amazing things in this community. It's the largest day we've ever had. Businesses will let their people off with pay, or if that doesn't happen, people are willing to take a day off, take a vacation day to be out there and help. Just to see the caring of people wanting to help, it really was overwhelming. And so many people were on social media saying, what a difference this is making. It's really helping us make a difference in our community. And what we want to do here at United Way is continue to connect people who want to help with opportunities to make a difference. So that's something really new. We're calling it the Volunteer Center, and we hope to do that throughout the year. We were at 16 of our local schools, and we had one of the schools tweeted to us. It was like an army of volunteers came over, and that one of the projects they did would have been assigned to two teachers, and it would have taken those teachers an entire year to finish that project that the volunteers did in one morning. So it was incredible. But I think it really does show the heart of the people in this area. Number one, the need is so great. You know, I think you can live in Springfield or in the Ozarks and really not pay attention to what the need is. You know, we can go to the grocery store, we can sit in church, and we don't think about the person sitting next to us might be struggling. Did they eat this morning? Will they be able to feed their children tonight? And because we know that 1 in 7 in our area don't know how they're going to eat tonight. And I believe that people care about that. Of course, it takes money to do lots of things, but there are a lot of times people just need to know somebody cares, that I will walk alongside you, that I know what the resources are and I'm going to help you through that. I think giving that hope is so important, and all of us can do that. And we want to be able to help every family that has a need. And our real goal is, you know, to work ourselves out of a job. So if we really can provide the safety net and then provide a pathway for sustainability for our families, then that is just our celebration. You can come to see us and we can connect you with one of our partner agencies, and you can always call 211. And our 24/7, 365 days a year, we're here to help all the families. And I think the other thing is, people say, well, Debbie, where is the United Way? Well, we're sitting here in the United Way building, but really, every person that donated an hour, they are the United Way in your community. Everybody that donates a dollar, whatever they donate, they're the United Way in our community. So we are a huge army of more than 2,000 people in this community that are ready to serve and help. There is hope and there is help, and there are people that care and are ready to give, to reach out and give a helping hand.
If you saw a child who needed help desperately, you'd help.
We all would, but we forget there are children in our community every day who we don't see, who do need help.
And the United Way of the Ozarks helps those kids through an organization called CASA.
United Way's 2015 Day of Caring, and Kelly Morris is helping an organization called CASA of Southwest Missouri.
Today we're helping them get ready for a mailing that they're doing. They have a gala in November that's a fundraiser for CASA, so we're putting together mailing pieces for that.
The executive director of CASA of Southwest Missouri is Beth Atchison.
CASA stands for Court-Appointed Special Advocates for Children. So we intercede and advocate on a child's behalf when they enter into the court system due to abuse or neglect. And our collaboration with United Way provides us the opportunity to work with other like-minded services.
The need for CASA is enormous. In just 1 year, 600,000 U.S. children will find themselves in foster care. The court-appointed special advocates who help those children are volunteers.
Our volunteers make up who we are, and so volunteering to advocate for a child is the best way to make a difference in our community.
One CASA volunteer is Gary Fair.
You know you're making an impact on the kids.
The chief information officer at BKD, Ferrer volunteered 2 years ago to become a court-appointed special advocate.
Other than raising kids, I don't have any training or any experience working with kids. So I felt like it was a pretty big leap for me to take. But CASA provided training. And it was an eye-opening experience to go through that training, to learn that there are just hundreds of kids in this area in foster care who need someone to advocate for them.
Gary Fair is a volunteer, but CASA has to have money to work.
So the funding we receive from United Way pays for one full-time staff person, and that staff then coordinates with 30 to 40 volunteers who serve between 75 and 100 children in our community.
I know that CASA would like to train more people. If they had more volunteers, they'd like to train them so we can do more work. But it takes resources. It takes financial resources, and United Way is a big part of that.
Which brings us back to these folks at the Day of Caring. Their work today will help countless kids tomorrow.
Sometimes we get stuck in our everyday lives and don't see what could be going on around us.
As heartbreaking as some of that is, together we are making our community better by helping our kids, by helping places like CASA.
1 in 7 children are abused in our area. We are trying to break that cycle of abuse. We know that a child who we do not intercede on their behalf today, 10 years from now, becomes the 18-year-old who's possibly facing poverty, homelessness, domestic violence. And so we're trying to stop that cycle of abuse by meeting the needs of the child today.
Not everyone would want to be a CASA volunteer. It's just not for everyone. But people can give to the cause through United Way.
I actually work in children's ministries and see the ramifications of some of these kids who may live in these kinds of environments. And so to have organizations like CASA being able to help these kids live the best life that they can and help them through tough situations, in return will help them become better leaders in the future.
A place where everyone belongs is the basis of how Developmental Center of the Ozarks formed 55 years ago.
Today it serves more than 1,000 members of our community with developmental disabilities and delays, alongside others who don't have special needs. The goal is to provide a place where people can learn and grow.
It's a place where disabilities don't matter and everybody belongs.
Makes you feel good.
DCO helps individuals who have disabilities, and our programs range from birth, if they have a diagnosed disability at birth, through adulthood, whether it's through children's programs or providing that assistance for adults. We all want to be independent. We all want to be able to provide for ourselves, and that's what we're trying to do here, is to help people be as productive as possible.
It's a goal that staff at Developmental Center of the Ozarks, or DCO, say needs to start at an early age. Marissa DeClue is the development director.
Being able to work with children from birth, and then here at our actual facilities with 6 weeks child care, really provides some of those opportunities for us to get in and make the greatest difference. If we can help a child be ready to go to kindergarten, ready to learn, we know that we're not only helping the community as a whole, but really focusing in on helping that child be successful.
DCO specializes in working with special needs children. About 40% of the children it serves have a diagnosed physical or intellectual disability, while almost all of the adults have a diagnosed disability, like Pam Stamp, who after 8 years with DCO is now employed by the organization.
I really like it, just to be here on time and do much and get down here and put your uniform on and get down there and pick up the dirty clothes and bring it back and put it in the wash machine and start the wash machine, and after it's done, put it in the dryer.
The programs really run the gamut from therapy to preschool and daycare services for kids with and without disabilities, and then programs for adults to continue learning, building on life skills, and employment training.
DeClue says the center is licensed for 130 kids, but it's almost at capacity.
The need is huge. And I'm not sure that we're ever going to, as a community, be able to fully meet that need, especially without people coming in behind us and continuing to cheer us on.
And cheering them on are organizations like United Way of the Ozarks. The funding goes directly to helping its programs.
Without the United Way and other community organizations and businesses helping us, we certainly wouldn't be the center that you see today. About a quarter of our funding comes from the community. And so if you took away a quarter of your household income, would you be able to survive? You probably could survive, but it's not going to be at the same quality of life that you're used to right now.
A quality of life that people like Stamps are achieving one fold at a time.
A lot of people help me, happy. I like it here. It just makes me feel good.
It's something that rarely happens.
The strength of numbers.
But when an army of volunteers come together on occasions like United Way of the Ozarks Day of Caring, it means the world to local service agencies.
One, two, three.
Having this large number of volunteers come in and tackle this project and get it done in one day is great for us from a budget perspective, but it's also great for us in terms of being able to serve kids.
Kimberly Shin Brown heads OCAC's Head Start program.
If we had to do this, it would be expensive and time consuming.
The Army, 2,000 volunteers strong, did everything from tree trimming and buffing to installing smoke alarms, aiding more than 90 organizations at 250 project sites in the Ozarks. Red Cross and its volunteers went door to door at this mobile home park, visiting 48 homes,
Hi.
Replacing 9 batteries, and installing 77 detectors.
Preparedness and education is very important during times of a disaster. You only have a few seconds to save your life and to save the life of your loved one.
By mobilizing the power of volunteers, United Way and the agencies it helps to fund help those in need. Support President and CEO Debbie Mead says isn't hard to find in the Ozarks.
I believe we have a strong belief in neighbor helping neighbor and people caring about each other and really having the desire to help.
Folks, that's our presentation for United Way. We hope that message has been delivered to you with a positive reinforcement on your part. We've tried to extend to you the message to live united. That's what we're all about, helping and volunteering. My colleagues in the media will all agree. Ladies and gentlemen,
live united!